James Bond, 007, international super spy, and world-renowned ladies' man.
Sorry, have we met before?
I think once, something in England.
This is James Bond 007 Bloodstone, available for the Xbox 360, the PS3, and PC. Like anything Bond, this game starts off with a bang. The story is a typical James Bond tale, filled with espionage, over-the-top action, and of course, witty one-liners.
Can I show you to a table?
No.
Bloodstone has you chasing biochemical terrorists across the globe from exotic locations like Greece, all the way to Siberia and China. In case you couldn't tell, this is the Daniel Craig version of Bond.
Oligarch. He owns oil wells, diamond mines.
UK soul singer Joss Stone is this game's Bond girl, and she provides her voice and likeness.
Sweetie, there are only 6 people worth dating in the world, and I've probably gone out with half of them.
She even sings the game's theme song. And speaking of Bond girls, Dame Judi Dench reprises her role as M from the films.
His business, sir, is international arms trading.
There is one side effect that I always get from playing a game like this. I start to talk like this for the rest of the afternoon. There's just something about English accents that I find contagious. They sound so dignified and proper.
That's why the helicopter is landing outside your hotel.
But enough about my problem. You want to know about Bloodstone.
Go on.
007 Bloodstone is a third-person cover-based shooter with an emphasis on hand-to-hand combat, along with a side order of vehicles.
That's it, boss. You're gaining on it.
It plays like your standard pop-and-stop shooter while you take cover behind objects, waiting for your enemies to pop up so you can fill them full of lead. Since you're a spy, sometimes blasting your way through a situation isn't the most sensible approach. So sometimes you're gonna have to whip out your English kung fu. Even though it looks like a lot's going on, this is handled with one simple button push. One of the unique elements in this game is called focus aim. Every time you take out an enemy in close combat, you earn a focus aim token. You can store up to 3 of these at a time, and use it by holding the left bumper while you pull the trigger. This gives Bond perfect aim, and it allows him to kill enemies instantly. You can chain up to 3 in a row. The downside to this is that it sometimes makes things too easy. There were times that I was able to slaughter an entire room of people in mere seconds. But in the end, it's optional, and you only have to use it as much as you feel like. The game comes from Bizarre Creations, the guys behind Project Gotham Racing and Blur. So you know what that means. That means cars. Most of the levels end with some type of vehicle section, usually with Bond's iconic Aston Martin, but sometimes you get to take a speedboat for a ride. They're mostly just chase scenes because your path is linear, but they're a nice diversion and they look impressive.
That's it, Nicole. Good.
And speaking of looks, let's talk about the graphics for a second. This game looks great. I didn't pay much attention to Bloodstone before I played it, so I was surprised to see just how good everything looks. Seriously, look at that water. Lest we not forget that James Bond is a spy, and spies have spy equipment. In this game, Bond's main method of infiltration is his cell phone. You can use it to scan and collect evidence, disable security cameras, or hack computers.
We've cloned that computer's hard drive.
To access your phone, you just press down on the D-pad, which causes the screen to turn green, highlighting various points of interest. To scan something, you just aim your phone at it and then press up on the D-pad. Occasionally, a rhythm-based minigame occurs, but they're incredibly simplistic. Unfortunately, that's where the gadgets end. I wish there was more emphasis on cool spy technology, but besides Bond's cell phone, there's nothing. I mean, how am I expected to save the world without the hidden darts in my cufflinks?
We'll do whatever you have to, by any means necessary, to find out who's behind this.
The other half of the Bloodstone package is online multiplayer. It has three different modes: Team Deathmatch, Objective, and Last Man Standing. Team Deathmatch is your standard Team Deathmatch, with two teams fighting to be the first to reach 50 kills. One team is made up of MI6 agents, and the other is composed of evil mercenaries. Objective mode is where one team tries to overtake three control points, and the other team tries to stop them. The final mode is Last Man Standing. It's basically like Team Deathmatch, except that you only get one life, and you play until everybody's eliminated on the other team. If you die, you enter spectator mode, and can watch the remaining members of your team fight for survival. It was my favorite mode, and I hope something like this comes to other games. I didn't spend a ton of time with it, but what I played was fun and lag-free. It isn't going to make you forget about Call of Duty or Halo, but it should provide entertainment for a weekend or two. Bloodstone is one of the better Bond games I've played in the last few years. Bizarre Creations got all of the important things right. The pop and stop shooting is well done, the story is action-packed, and the graphics are amazing. There's room for improvement, but I think this is the direction the franchise should go in the future. To me, Uncharted 2 is the blueprint for how to do a cinematic action-adventure game, and I would love to see a Bond game with that level of depth. So if you're in the mood to save the world from terrorists, drive fancy cars, and hang out with sexy women, then Bloodstone should fit the bill.
It's nice to see you, Nicole. I'm sure you've got a plane to catch.